Είναι πρωταγωνιστής Ελλάδος. Hello. Hello.
Hi.
Oh, sorry. Okay. Hi, can you hear me? Can you hear me now? Okay, thank you. Can you see me clearly in the video? Okay, very good. All right, so welcome to 5-1 Talk. My name is Teacher Arthur Jerome. Nice to meet you. Your name is Jared, right? Okay, nice to meet you, Jared. How are you today? Okay, good to hear that. Okay, Jared, so before we start our lesson, can you tell me what do you do for fun or what are your hobbies in life? Okay, nice. And who is your favorite NBA player? Okay. And do you play basketball all the time or every weekends only? Or if you have free time? Okay, nice. Okay. So, Jared, today I'm going to help you improve your grammar skills, okay? Meaning to say, your ability to construct simple and complex sentences. And also, I'm going to check your pronunciation. So, today we're going to learn new words. And we're going to use those new words to make a sentence. So, are you ready for today's lesson, Jared? Okay, let's start. Okay. So, first question, Jared, what can you see in the picture? Okay, nice. Salad and meat. What else? Do you see anything aside from salad and meat? All right. Okay, nice. Very nice. Okay. So, yes, that is the correct answer. So, but when someone asks you to describe a picture, you should always answer in a complete sentence. All right. So, instead of saying some vegetables and meat, you can say in the picture. Okay, I can see some salad and meat. And right. Also, I can see a glass a glass of wine, all right? And right, and other food. Okay, so let me send my correction in the chat box. So again, I will ask you the question. Please answer. You should say, Jared, what can you see in the picture? Okay, please look at the chat box. I send the correction in the chat box. Can you see it? All right, thank you so much. So, Jared, in this lesson, you will learn to say food for dinner. Let's go. So, our lesson for today, Jared, the title is Please Read. Please read the title. Okay, I'd like to have some noodles. All right. Okay, so let's go to part one. Let's do some warm up. So, Jared, here is a question for you. What do you often eat for dinner? Okay, so again, what do you often eat for dinner? You say, so you can say, I often eat rice with, let's say, noodles for dinner. Okay, so let me give you an example answer. I often eat rice with fish for dinner. Okay. All right. So, or you can say, I often eat fruit for dinner. Okay. I often eat fruit for dinner. Or you can say, I often eat. All right. Good job. Fantastic. All right, fantastic. So here is a question again, Jared. Do you usually eat at home or not? Oh, right, very good. Because eating food at home is safe and healthy, right? Compared if you eat outside. We don't know who how the food was made, or we don't know where the food came from. Very nice. Okay, now we're going to make a sentence with the word rice. So can you give me a sentence, Jared? I'm going to check your grammar skills. Give me a sample sentence using the word rice. Use it in a sentence. Rice. Chinese people, okay, like eating rice very much. All right, that is a nice sentence, but it's better if you say, you can say, Chinese people, or you can simply say, Chinese people likes to eat rice most of the time. Okay, let me send my correction. There you go. All right, how about fruit? Use the word fruit in a sentence. Okay, eating fruit every day is good to our health. Very good. Good job. How about noodles? Use noodles in the sentence. Okay, I like to eat noodles. Very good. Good job. Okay, let's go to the next page. So let's go to part two. We're going to learn new words and expressions. Please read the instructions, Jared. Go. Okay, so go through the words and phrases. Okay, the first word is hangry. Hangry. Yes. Jared, are you hangry? Okay, me too. I'm not hungry because I already eat my dinner earlier. Okay, so use the word hungry in a sentence. Go. This time, try to make a longer sentence, okay? Or longer sentences. So you can practice your grammar skills. For example, you can say, being hungry is not good. We should always make sure to eat at the right time. Okay, so that is a complex sentence or a long sentence. How about you, Jared? Can you make one? Can you make a complex sentence using the word hungry? Go. Okay, the people in the poor areas are usually hungry. The people or yes, that is a good sentence, or you can say Most people, okay, in most people living, okay, in poor areas are usually the ones who are usually the ones who are hungry because the lack of money, right? Because if you don't have money, you can't buy food to eat, right? So we have to work in order for us to earn some money that we can use to buy food. Okay, Jared, please read the sentence again. You should say, right, okay. Next, let me give you some synonyms of hungry. When we say synonyms, words that has the same meaning. Okay, let me find here some synonyms of hungry. You can also say starvation, right? Starvation. What else? Let's see. Related words. One moment. Hungry, hungry. Okay, here. Okay. Starvation or voraciousness, okay? Voraciousness. Or appetite. Okay, those are the synonyms. Another example of a word, hungry, please read this sentence. Please read the sample sentence. Yes, do you agree, Jared? Do you agree with this statement that wasting food is a sin? Because many people, okay, it's not a sin. Yeah, sometimes we have to, especially those foods that are not suitable or not edible to eat, we can throw them away or feed them to dogs and cats. Okay, next, noodles. We already make a sentence earlier with noodles. Let's go to pizza. Okay, do you eat pizza, Jared? Okay, please say, yes, I do. Yes, I do. Okay, good. Can you make a sentence using the word pizza? Use it in a sentence. Okay. People in the West like eating pizza. Or you can say people in the West likes to eat pizza. Let's say most of the time. Okay, please read the correct sentence. You should. Right, okay. I will give you another example sentence of the word pizza. This one. Okay, please read. I thought I dressed up the frozen pizza with a few extra tomatoes and olives. Your turn, Jared, please read. Olives. All right, good job. All right, next, go out for. So this is an expression or a phrase. Go out for. Can you give me a sentence using the expression or phrase go out for? For example, you can say, I'm going out, okay, I'm going out for dinner with my friends tonight. All right. I'm going out for dinner with my friends tonight. Okay, how about you, Jared? Can you give me a sentence using the phrase go out for? Use it in a sentence. Usually go out to play basketball during weekends. Okay, very nice. How about go to? Please use go to in a sentence. Example, you can say, I go to school every day. I go to swimming, okay, on summer holiday. All right, that is a good sentence, but it's better if you say, I go to the beach during summer holiday. I go to the beach for swimming, okay, during summer holiday. All right, please read the correct sentence. You should say,
I go to
All right. Now let's have some exercise. You just need to fill in the blanks with the correct word or phrases. Example, letter A. They go out for dinner. Letter B. Please read and your answer. Jared, go. Jack. Correct. Letter C. This is a large. Okay. Bruce is so. Bruce is so. Okay, correct. Mary is eating. What is Mary eating? Mary is eating what, Jared? She is. There you go. Very good. Good job. Okay, let's go to part three. Go through the sentences. Okay, first question. What do you often have for dinner, Jared? You can say, for my dinner. All right, second question. What does Emma eat for her dinner? What does Emma eat for her dinner? Okay, good job. All right, let's go to part four. We're going to have a role play. I will be Alice and you are Mike. Okay? Let's go. Your turn. You are
I'm so hungry. Shall we go?
Sure. What do you want to eat? Maybe pizza? I'm not sure. Let's go to the restaurant first. Okay, let's switch. You are Alice. I am Mike. I'm so hungry. Shall we go out for dinner, Alice? I want to have some noodles. What about you? All right, very good. Okay, so we're running out of time. Let's or let me give you some feedback. All right, let's start with your grammar. You can actually construct short or simple sentences, Jared, which is very good. Good job with that. But I highly recommend or advise that you also practice constructing longer sentences. Okay. And with your pronunciation, I didn't hear any mispronounced words, so good job. But still, You have to keep practicing, okay, by watching English movies or reading English books. See you next time, Jared. Thank you so much. We're going to continue our lesson. Bye bye.